Alright, I'll play first. Looks like a keeper to me. A little bit on the slow end, but I have removal and creatures, and I'm not gonna die quickly. My hand is bad against the card Gnarled Scarhide, but once I draw a swamp, I can put down Disciple of Phoenix, block it forever, and get some card advantage. Luckily, he didn't have it this time. Brain Maggot, extremely annoying to play against. I can't kill it with either of my next infusions, and it's going to take my best card. Probably one of the best cards he could play on his turn two there. If I was him, I would take my Leo Crocoda. Well, things have not been going great for me so far this draft. I mean, I drafted a very good deck, but hopefully I draw Viper's Kiss. Hold my swamp there to once again conceal information about the card that I drew. Should I add Desecration Plague for the third game if I were to get there? It does kill Brain Maggot, which is nice. I'll be taking one here. And the Servant of Timuret. That I can beat. Might as well just plop this guy down there. Stop myself from taking a lot of damage. Swamp and swamp. A little bit unfortunate there. I suppose I could have cast Nyx Infusion on this, and then I would have been able to Disciple for 3 instead of 2, but seems like a bit of a waste of a Nyx Infusion, given that, his creature is still a 1 regenerator inspired. That card can still do what that card is intended to do. Hopefully I draw Eidolon of Blossoms. That is, like, by far my best draw. Oh, I'm gonna be blocking your guy, because I don't like taking one damage. Odunis River Trawler. Not a very exciting draw step there. Just gonna fire off a Nyx Infusion. No real reason why. No real reason not to, Saving myself a little bit of damage. Plus, he knows that I have it, and, Spiteful Blow would be a nice draw, as well as Sip of Hemlock. Reaper of the Wilds. Or once again, Eidolon of Blossoms. Especially because if he kills it, I've got this. That's a real thing of beauty. Ew. A 3-2? Yeah, that's not ideal. Because now I kind of want to just cast my River Trawler as is to try to block this thing and preserve my life total. I figure I could only wait one more turn until the damage I take from his creature becomes too much. So if I say go, I'm gonna go to 14, down to 11, effectively 10. Yeah, I think I'll wait exactly one turn before I decide to put my creature out there. I'm risking three life for the upside of drawing an enchantment creature that will trade off in combat and allow my River Trawler to provide a little bit of card advantage. I'll take my three. Black Oak of Odunis. Another forest. That's a worst case scenario draw once again. Just gonna put this thing out there and hope I don't die soon. Really need to draw, read the bones, or, anything. Yuck. Would stand to reason that that would have happened anyways, so seems as if I risked nothing trying to draw an enchantment creature. But also, the clock is ticking, and I'm not gonna last much longer against this beatdown. So, kind of need to draw something immediately. Dark Betrayal. Yeah, I'd say that'll do. Let's kill that thing. I'm gonna get my Lucrecoda back. Cast it. But there is still the problem of the Servant of Tymaret, so I have 7 turns until I'm dead. Until I'm truly just dead. I don't know if there exists very much that will kill that servant. I basically have to just hope my opponent taps low foolishly, and then I can kill it. Like if he main phase plays a 6-drop, and then I spiteful blow it. Otherwise, there's not much. Wonder if I have any cards in my deck that gain life and can bail me out of this jam. Reaper of the Wilds, not terrible. Not terrible at all. I suppose if I was able to kill the Black Oak, then it would be easier for me to minimize the Servant of Tymaret, or at least just race it. I suppose that's my new plan, just try to kill the Black Oak somehow. But my life total is ticking down. Slowly but surely, my life total is being reduced to zero. And we have a big spell here. Griffin Dreamfinder. That's a bit annoying. Hopefully I top deck Spiteful Blow immediately and I can kill that Servant. My opponent returns his Nyx Infusion, which doesn't really do a whole lot here. Painseer. Very bad draw. That's a card that is quite a bit better on turn 2 and not turn 10 when you're at 5 life. Here I'm just going to do an attack, just see what happens. Doesn't seem like my opponent has very many good blocks. And he doesn't block at all. Should I Monstrous the Lucrecoda and put him to 16? I think I should probably cast Nyx Infusion on Griffin Dreamfinder so that I, you know, don't take one damage and that'll buy me another turn. And I might as well just cast the Painseer. It's not doing me much good in my hand. I don't like that I reveal the information to my opponent that I don't have anything, but also, I mean, in a perfect world, he'll just cast Nyx Infusion on it, and then I may scry with my Reaper of the Wilds. Get deeper in my deck to a card that does anything. This is the slow bleed to death. And it's the true slow bleed because it's lasted quite a while. I have about 8 more minutes than my opponent. All right, well, I view that as a mistake by my opponent because now I get to scry. Yep, scrying a land to the bottom, effectively drawing a card. What do we have here? Swamp. That's not going to do very much for me. I really can't think of much that's in my deck that will allow me to win. I guess there is Hero's Downfall, so I've got that. Also, I've got Backdoor, Eidolon of Blossom into lots of different things. I could draw an enchantment, you know, somehow stitch together a board in which I could race much easier. Servant of Time Red blocks Ravenous Lucrecoda. Guess I'll just pass priority. I mean, yeah, it doesn't do much for me to Monstrous immediately. Yeah, I mean, the regenerate doesn't do anything here. Come on, deck. Nope, bottom. I'm going to play a land here so that I may Monstrous at end of turn and still have Hexproof available for my Reaper of the Wilds. Alrighty. The Black Oak continuing to just kill me. Black Oak too strong. Maybe it was a bad play to hold that river trawler, but I had so little going on for me at that point that the possibility of drawing like a Nyxborn Wolf, trading off with the Brain Maggot, using the trawler to pick up the Nyxborn Wolf just seemed so appealing. Also, I was at like 15 or 16 life. I mean, obviously with the bent. Oh yeah, I forgot about the Nyx Infusion that killed it anyways, so wouldn't have even worked. But if he hadn't had that, and I could go back, knowing how the game plays out, it would have been better for me to cast it a turn sooner to just trade. Well, that resolves. Given that last turn my opponent blocked with Servant of Tymerat with the intention of regenerating, that means that surely I could win if I drew a removal spell now. Yeah, he's just tapped down low, so the time for luck is now, deck. Give it to me. Not actually terrible. Does it do anything is the question. Probably not. It probably does straight stone cold nothing. Because my Lucrecoda basically, I mean whatever, I'll just cast it. It's pretty bad. If it had been a Golden Hind Ox, it wouldn't do anything. Actually, it would have been nice if it was a Golden Hind Ox. I could have made the Black Oak block the Reaper, and then the game would be slightly different in that my opponent would have to attack me with the Servant of Tymerat instead of blocking and regenerating. But given that I'm at 3 and he's at 24, probably would not have affected the game in any meaningful way. And extremely unlucky for me, it looks like my opponent is quickly running out of reasons to tap out in his main phase and not have regeneration mana open. The less cards he has in his hand, the less likely it is that he is able to find a reason to tap his mana so that I could get lucky and draw my Hero's Downfall to kill this guy without regeneration mana up. Doesn't look like it's going to be my day. Also, this Laguna Band Elder is like just mashed together in my opponent's permanence through no reason or logic. Just Magic Online being Magic Online. Just be mindful of the fact that my opponent has 4 creatures and not 3 like it looks like he has. Especially because one of them has Bestow. Like, if I was a new player, I would just think that it was this bestowed on this when it's just clearly not. Not sure why I said clearly when there's nothing clear about what's happening here, but it is not bestowed. This is a Laguna Band Elder, separate. This is what it should look like. That's what it does look like. All right, well, 2 life is not very many. Viper's Kiss. Sadly, I would need that to stop the Oak or the Servant. It cannot stop both. Oh, let me think for a second. So if I put it on the Oak, he would just use the Oak in response and tap the Servant, and then attack me on the following turn. And if I put it on the Servant, he could still just tap the Servant with the Oak. So now that I've acknowledged that this card doesn't immediately do anything to stop his combo, in fact, it actually does nothing, is it in my best interest to just cast it on the Nyxborn Eidolon to scry and hope to hit something? It's not like I have an Ilias Disciple, which would be great. I don't have much. I know what the Viper's Kiss does do. If I were to draw a Spiteful Blow, or Sip of Hemlock, or Hero's Downfall on the next turn, I could just cast Viper's Kiss on the Servant of Tymerat, and then kill it on the next turn. So, I think that... Well, the thing is, if I cast Viper's Kiss on his guy, he'll respond and put a Regeneration Shield on it, And so then I can't kill it. So I guess I need to just Viper's Kiss now. I think I'll just do it after combat, because if I do it before combat, he'll just regenerate in response and it won't do me any good. So my path to victory is just cast Viper's Kiss on his guy at the end of combat, and then next turn hope to draw a removal spell. It is highly unlikely. Be mindful of that, but it is possible. I guess maybe I could have just Viper's Kissed first, just to hope my opponent made a mistake and didn't regenerate in response. Whatever, though. That's just so, so unlikely. Also, not even clear that it's a good play, because it gives away information about my hand, and it's possible then that he will play differently. Alright, down to one. Read the Bones, no longer an out. I guess I could have held Viper's Kiss on the off chance I draw Eidolon of Blossoms, but as I explained previously, it's so, so unlikely for that to work, because he can use the Viper's Kiss in response, or he can regenerate in response, and then I'm kind of just dead. Just playing out the 1-3. Really need to draw some kind of removal here, or life gain. Don't think it exists, though. Snake of the Golden Grove. Well, that's a kind of life gain that, you know, probably won't end up working out for me. Yeah, we're dead. Sadly, we are dead. I think I did give myself the best chance to win, though. Nope, you go away. Please somehow, like, misclick and give me 4 life. Or, like, get confused with how the Black Oak works with the Servant. Nope. Not today. Yep, death. Oh well, good game. What were my outs? Spiteful Blow, Hero's Downfall, Sip of Hemlock, and yep, nothing else.